The equation that calculates the minimum wall thickness needed to contain the pressurized fluid is given as follows. In this equation, we have the design pressure of the fluid in PSI, and we'll talk more about this later, the outside diameter of the pipe in inches, which should not include any coating thickness, and the allowable stress of the pipeline material, also in PSI. AWWA Manual of Practice 11, or just M11 for short, states that we should assume a maximum of 50% of the allowable stress. This means that we should also insert here a factor of safety of 2 into this equation. Please note that the allowable stress is a function of the specific type of steel used as determined by the appropriate ASTM standard. Those listed in M11 include ASTM A36 steel, as well as A283, A570, and A572. When I was getting paid for doing these calculations, we typically specified ASTM A570 grade 30, meaning 30 KSI as the maximum allowable stress. Realizing that not everyone everywhere uses ASTM standards to define the properties of a given type of steel, the key lesson you should learn is that whatever maximum allowable stress you use in the calculation is directly tied to the material of the pipe. Therefore, when writing your design specifications, you should expressly note which material you are selecting so that the contractor purchases the correct steel. Later, when the contractor shows you what he bought, you can check his shop drawing against the calculation assumptions you made earlier. Now that you're all bored to death, let's move on. Design pressure. If we look at this simple hydraulic schematic, you may initially think perhaps the design pressure is merely the hydrostatic head shown here as the difference between Z2 and Z1. But then you would quickly correct yourself, because this is only true when the pump is off and the water is simply flowing down the hill. When the pump is on, we add energy into the system to overcome the head loss due to friction and fittings. So when the pump is running, the maximum pressure occurs just downstream of the pump and can be calculated by converting the static head and the dynamic head into pressure units by multiplying by the unit weight of the fluid. However, even this calculation is not good enough because it does not account for the surge pressure. Surge pressure is a transient or non-steady condition that can be caused by a number of factors. The most common are when the pump turns on, when the pump shuts off, or when a valve closes in the system. Let's assume that you have water traveling down a pipe at velocity V. In a short time, a valve closes in the pipeline, causing the water in the pipe to crash into the valve. Depending on the velocity, the pipeline reacts by expanding slightly and then creating a return wave headed in the opposite direction. This return wave then bounces its way back through the system, pounding every pipe fitting like a hammer, which is why it is often called water hammer. In another video, I cover the details of hydraulic transients and the effect known as water hammer a little more, but you should know now that this needs to be accounted for in our equation for the design pressure. A distribution system is divided by pressure zones. And given the guidelines applied to water systems, the minimum operating pressure is 150 psi for one pressure zone. Because surge analyses are quite complicated and require that much of the system be in final design before they can even be remotely accurate, we often simply add an additional 50 psi to handle the surge pressure. What this means is, for example, that a system pumping only one pressure zone will have a design pressure of 200 psi. A given water agency will specify a maximum and minimum static head, and the difference between these two numbers is the additional pressure needed to pump up to the next pressure zone, which in this example, this is 50 psi. Therefore, a water system pumping two pressure zones at a time with the same static head criteria will need to account for 200 psi of operating pressure with the same 50 psi of surge, making the design pressure in this example 250 psi. A similar procedure can be applied to systems that pump three pressure zones at a time.